Another show of hands here. Have you ever been arrested?
Yeah, it's a hell of a party they've got over there. So that is the Republican primary debate for the Colorado's 4th congressional district. A whole bunch of candidates there. You might have noticed Lauren Boebert, who's deciding to run for Congress there. And by run, I mean run from her actual district to this one. And you saw of the 9 candidates, 6 of them had to raise their hand when asked if they've ever been arrested. And lest you interpret that as a show of honesty, you can still lie, as Lauren Boebert did. She said in that segment that she had been arrested only once for failing to appear in court for careless driving, what she called in the debate, quote, a simple traffic violation that was unpaid. But the local news media have reported at least 2 additional arrests. In one incident in 2015, Boebert told police officers who were arresting her that she had, quote, friends at Fox News and that the arrest would be national news. Now that is an allegation. We can't say for sure that she would say something like that to the cops, except I have seen her, I get her vibe. She would totally say that to the cops. In any event, this isn't just about Boebert. The Republicans of that district are gonna have their choice of any number of former arrestees. And so the interesting thing was that the follow-up question wasn't like, for each of you, why were you arrested? They went a different direction. Take a look.
Given the hands that have come up here, how should voters consider and weigh a candidate's criminal history? And I think we gotta ask that here, because you know what the lamestream media is gonna do with all this stuff. How do we talk to voters about our criminal history and how should they value it?
And we need to be upfront. We're all sinners. We all fall short of the glory of God. We all ask for forgiveness and move on from there.
Amen.
That is how it works for Republicans. Joe Biden doesn't get to just be a sinner and we move on from there, whatever. Did you notice that? For some reason, if you're a Republican, it's totally cool. So that guy, the guy who asked the question, sees a whole crowd of Republicans and almost all of them have to raise their hands. And his concern isn't why are a bunch of criminals running for office, or maybe some of them were arrested for something good, arrested at a protest or something like that. I don't know. Maybe like you're the Ohio pastor was being, you know, like charged because you were sheltering the unhoused during a storm. I don't know, but he doesn't care. His only concern is that the lamestream media might do something with that. And so like according to a straw poll, Lauren Boebert isn't even particularly doing well. But whoever she gets beat by has a very good chance of also, like her, having been arrested at least once. Yaz, I want to start with you. What do you think about this clown car of Republicans?
Yeah, well, it's like you said, you know, sometimes good people get arrested. Sometimes the charges against them are bunk. Sometimes they learn from the experience and they turn their lives around and then they go on to, you know, work in public service and improve the system from the inside. These aren't those people, right? The people sitting at that table are not using their experiences to make life easier or better for people like them. Even Lauren Boebert, she said it was just a simple traffic violation. And we know from records that it was much more than that. She was arrested for reckless driving. And then she was arrested another time for disorderly conduct. And then she missed her court date. She didn't pay the fine. So it was a few things. And she kind of glossed over a lot of that there. But Lauren Boebert is running for Congress, not because she wants to be a public servant, just like what we were talking about with Matt Gaetz. She's doing it because she likes the money, she likes the attention, and she likes the influence, right? She's done remarkably little for the people in her district, so much so that they know it. And she was facing such bad reelection odds that she just abandoned them and hopped over to another district. So, and even here in this new District 4 that she's running in, her odds aren't great.
Yeah, listen, Martin Luther King was arrested. I think Gandhi was arrested. These people are not Martin Luther King or Gandhi. These people are atrocious. Again, I don't know their individual cases and I'm just going out on a limb here. Given the fact that they're the Boebert types and my guess is that that they were probably arrested on. I would love to find out why they were arrested. My guess is that some of them were arrested on like drunken behavior or thinking that they have white privilege so they can speak to the cops of the way they want to. Like Lauren Boebert said, I have friends at Fox. So again, being arrested doesn't mean you can't go on and become a good leader. But the problem is that these people are not that. And the idea that they always turn to God and go, well, God says that I'm okay now. But then they don't go on and do many godly or Jesus-like things. They seem to go, they become more cruel. You know, that's your Lauren Boebert. It's not like she was arrested and then had a wake-up call and said, oh my, you know, I've now made my peace with God and I'm not gonna go feed people who are underprivileged. No, she now goes into Congress and just yaps her big mouth about everything that is totally nonsensical. She's basically a TikToker or a influencer or whatever. I mean, if she were she's like Marjorie Taylor Greene. If they were like physical fitness gurus online and just posted their opinions, you'd be like, oh, look at, you know, this person's kind of dumb. They got voted into Congress, which makes you think they're not dumb. The people who voted for them are dumb. Like, at what point do these people that vote for these types at what point do they go, is this person doing anything for me and for my district and making my life better? They don't do that. And vice versa, when somebody like Joe Biden shows up and goes, yo, I passed the infrastructure bill, which actually is making your life better, they don't seem to grasp that and go with it. It blows my mind.
Yeah, for me, the reaction from the crowd was the weirdest part, like why they thought that was awesome. I would have higher expectations in a crowd of candidates like that big. But and again, I don't know why all of them were arrested. We know some of the arrests of Lauren Boebert. One of the individuals there had been speeding while drunk and possessing a gun that they weren't supposed to have. So, you know, great people all around. But I want to leave you on a more positive note, because we have been critical of the people in that room. But to be fair, they're not necessarily that dumb, because according to a straw poll, Boebert is in fifth. So it could be worse. They could still prefer her and they're not going in that direction, so that's good. Anyway, we'll see what ends up happening. The desperation ploy of leaving your district and going there it looks really bad for Lauren Boebert. But doing that and then not even coming in like the top three is gonna look way, way worse.
Thanks for watching. If you become a member, you get to watch all this ad-free, except for, of course, this ad. Still, hit the join button below.